Hilltop Refuge Regional. I flipped heads. I got West Virginia here. Here we go, set for tip-off. Cinderella UMBC knocked off Wisconsin in the first round. See if they can keep their hot streak going. Jordan McCabe had a good first round for for West Virginia. Culver catches it outright. What a pass. Unloads. Hands it from inside. He's got two. Number 33. Gets it outright. Finishes in close. They take a 2-point lead. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy Wilson, who has some info for us.
But just before the game, when I talked to the Mountaineers coach, he's aware that they're not going to get any free passes, and he said he told his players as hard as they had to work for a win in the regular season, they're going to have to work twice as hard here in the tournament. They handled the first round well, but he wants to see them work even harder here in the second round.
Then, thank you, Tracy. The D was really ready for him there. That's how you do it. Keep the heat on. For the misstep, and then capitalize. Goes up. The uptake is a good one, and so is the lower, by number 34. And they're now out in front by two. Left side. Anticipates the pass. About 5.5 minutes left in the half. Finger. Passes it to the high post. Matthews Jr. has it right wing. That is such an important part of the game, Burns. Always keep working on the offensive boards. This right wing. Number 33 picks it up. Gently drops it in. They narrow the gap to two. Number 5 brings it up court. Number 34 catches it on the elbow. Number 5 kicks it out to the wing. High post. Tosses it up. Comes up empty from 20 feet out. Still a 2-point lead. Number 30. Dishes it to the wing. Hook free, but it's recovered by number 22. Culver inbounds the ball. Just over 4 minutes left in the half. Number 5 has it right wing. Launches one from beyond the arc. Held in by number 33. And it's still knotted up 8. Jackson fires the 3. Culver reels it in. And it's still all knotted up. Number 5 passes it to the wing. Hook loose. But it's recovered by Matthews Jr. The steal by Maryland Baltimore Cade. A little too much activity there, and he forgot to squeeze it. Always protect the ball, Burns. Keeps the turnaround. And in the front, they're in front, 10-8. Number 13 takes it up, hits it, and it's all batted up 10.
It looks like they're playing really.
Baseline goes up. The layup good, down to the 34. And they lead by 2. Spike down. The Mountaineers will retain possession. First team are going to shake things up a little bit with some shots. Number 33 inbounds the ball. McBride off the inbound pass. Good. He's got 3. Number 50 passes it up court. Kicks it out to the perimeter. Number 22 knocked loose, but it's recovered by number 22. Dishes it to the free throw line. The layup flipped in by number 13. But they're still behind by 3. 2:34 left in the first half. Number 33 catches it right side. Maryland BC has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
Hilltopper Refuge bringing us this part of the bracket here. We appreciate the Hogan family for sponsoring us along the way in this tournament.
Gets it, right wing, poked away, but it's recovered by number 22. Jackson catches to the right wing, the steal by Matthews Jr.
I'd love to see that. He's looking around and pass. Such a deep one.
Low block, tipped away. He's it to the top of the key. Jackson hits it. Now down by 1:23 left in the first half. Number 33 kicks it out to the outside. It's deflected, and it's scooped up by number 15. The D was really ready for him there.
That's how you do it. Keep the heat on. Wait for the mistake, and then capitalize.
Matthews Jr. catches it, top of the key. The last shot missed in three-point range.
What a good job on the defense to make him think about that shot.
Skip pass, right wing, hook three, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by West Virginia. Both teams are making substitutions. Number 21 inbounds the ball, takes it up. Would have grabbed the lead, but it was missed by number 15.
They can go 2-for-1 here, Vern, if they hurry it up.
Number 5, the 15-footer. Number 33 snatches the rebound.
How smart by the big fella to get that rebound.
Has it, top of the key, and it's got it up by number 5. Nice little crossover. Fishes to the low block. First half comes to an end with the score 15-14. Give us your opinion on the first half, Bill.
What a battle this has been.
Halftime here in the Hilltopper Refuge Regional. Thank everybody for tuning in.
We're all set to begin the second half. Number 33 inbounds it to start the second half. McNeil. Off the mark from the line. They're still up by 1. N- Number 22 has it outright. That last shot missed from just inside the arc. Let's send it down to Tracy Wilson.
Well, at halftime, I talked with the Mountaineers coach. He said that he isn't satisfied with the small lead and is going to try to force the issue in the second half. Coach said that even though his starters had plenty of energy, he would still rotate in his bench players. He said that it wasn't a question of fatigue, but more of a method of showing different looks on offense. Back to you, Vern.
Okay, Tracy. We'll see if he got the message across. Passing out left. Matthews Jr. releases. Nails it from the wing. He's 1-for-3 for the game. Stolen by number 33. Off target on the last play. The steal by Maryland Baltimore County.
These fans are going nuts, Vern. Could this building get any louder?
Gets it right wing. Left wing, number 22.
Oh, snap. UMBC tied it up. Looking to try and pull off an upset here. Another one.
McNeil dishes to the left wing. Matthews Jr. catches it. Far side. Just over 5 minutes left in the second half. Number 22, Jackson for the lead. He's 1-for-4 from downtown. Catches it, top of the key. Number 34, passes to the left. Number 5.
McCabe hits a 3.
Number 33, inbound the ball. Dumps it down low. He grabs the rebound. Matthews Jr. didn't get that rebound by accident. He didn't know what it is. This crowd couldn't be any happier. Just listen to the people in this building. They increased their lead to 4. Jackson takes it up. Foul! Number 30 inbounds the ball. Leads in with the pass. Number 33 strips it in for 3. They cut it to 1. Number 34 bounces it to the left. Culver backs in. Number 34 has it on the free throw line. Matthews Jr. from 20 feet out. Doesn't go. But they're still out in front by 1. Dumps it to the paint. Number 13 with the shot. Good pass by number 33. And they now go up by 1.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in, Vern. Damn it.
Taylor shoots. He's off from 3. The defense did a really good job of closing out of the shooter back there.
Well, you have to stay in his face or he'll free you.
Stolen by number 5. Dumps it off. Culver. It's deflected, but it's tracked down by West Virginia. Gets it right wing. Matthews Jr. knocks down the trifecta. 9 points, and he leads all in scoring. The Retrievers all timeout. They trail by 2. 2:56 left in the game. Well, let's get back to the action. Number 30 inbounds the ball. Jackson feeds it to the wing. Knocked free. but it's recovered by Jackson. Dishes it to the right wing. The Retrievers will get this one back. The Retrievers will take a timeout. They're trailing by two. 2:35 left in the game. They're going to have to hurry. Number 22, from long range, he rips down the rebound. He'll make that one most of the time.
But the D got a break on that one.
Culver passes it to the wing. Matthews Green gets it to fall. Well, it looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball. Number 33 inbounds the ball. 2:10 left in the game. Number 30 catches it right wing. Number 22 gets the bucket from 18 feet. He's got 7. Pass left side. Matthews Jr. He rips down the rebound.
Offensive rebound didn't come to him by accident. He knew right where to be.
The crossover gets it baseline. Haley passes it back to the elbow. Left wing takes the shot. The crew won't fall. They still have a 3-point lead. Number 33 brings it up to 4. Knocks free. Skips it to the wing. Number 22 lets loose the 3. Shakes it. And we're now all tied up 30. Number 34, backs down. Dumps it inside. Number 5 has it high post. Bounce pass. Number 34, plays up, hammers it in. Number 33, inbounds the ball. This is a crucial possession. Getting set to inbound the ball.
Coming down to the wire in the second round games here in the Hilltopper Refuge Regional.
Number 22 tosses it up, can't take the lead.
Only a few games left in this regional.
No denying him on that one.
Out of bounds. Touch last by Maryland, Baltimore County. Number 5 hands it off.
Oh, a big turnover on the shot clock violation. Someone's got to take charge out there, Vern, and make sure they find a good shot.
Number 13 inbounds the ball.
Oh, no.
Number 22 for the lead. Can't get it. Number 13 has picked up his first foul of the game.
I don't think there's going to be enough time for them to even foul enough times to...
Number 5 shoots it. No luck.
West Virginia barely slips on by.
32-30. Now we'll bring you our player of the game.
Next game up on the bracket here in the Hilltopper Refuse and Recycling Regional will be Marquette versus Seton Hall. Marquette a 10, Seton Hall a 2. Let's see what the coin flip says. Heads. I'm playing with Seton Hall. No Marcus Howard for me this game.
Get ready for College Hoops 2K8. The Seton Hall Pirates square up against
okay, Seton Hall versus Marquette, Hilltopper Refuge Regional. This is the 10 versus 2 seed. I played with Marquette first round. Did I play with Seton Hall? No, I played with Northern Kentucky, so I haven't played with Seton Hall yet. Unsure of what I'm getting myself into. Looks like they got a big man though, and one. I don't know what that was. Thought it was a foul, but I guess not.
Wasn't enough.
Good defense, not letting them jam it home. Bold pass.
Stolen away by Marquette. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Tracy Wilson, for an update. What do you have for us, Tracy?
Earlier today, I talked with the Golden Eagles coach. He's aware that they're not going to get any free passes, and he said he told his players as hard as they had to work for a win in the regular season, they're going to have to work twice as hard here in the tournament. They handled the first round well, but he wants to see them work even harder here in the second round. Vern?
Thanks, Tracy. That last long two was missed by number 22.
Kane went after that rebound hard. Great
ball. Laid up and in by Howard. But they're still behind by one. Catches it down low. Number 25 wipes the board off the window.
Don't put anything weak up like that.
I'm sure his coach will be telling him that. One on one. Fires from the right guard. Howard pulls the trigger. Powell
did a good job to grab that rebound.
Hilltopper Refuge for all of your recycling and trash pickup needs. Call the Hogan family. They'll take care of you. They bleed purple. Proud Hilltopper sponsors for everything we do.
Kane gets it inside. Howard to take the lead. It's the layup. They now lead by one. He's doubled up. Deflected. And it's picked up by Marquette. Shoots it. The D was really waiting for him there.
That's how you do it. Keep the heat on. Wait for the misstep and then capitalize.
Passing. Baseline. Tip. And it's scooped up down to the 25.
I'd love to see that. He's working around then pass. Such a defense.
Number 25. Howard watches it and blocks. He's got seven. Number 22, inbounds the ball.
Oh, snap.
The Pirates were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
Oh, Vern, they've got to communicate a little bit better out there so they don't have any more passes like that one.
Kane, way up court.
I can't leave him open. That's not going to be good.
Seton Hall has been on the wrong side of this long run, and Tracy's got a report for us.
Coach Hall is not at all happy with the drought they're going through and told his assistants to find a way, any way, to turn this one around.
Thanks, Tracy. No good on the last layup by number 25.
There's nothing he can do but shake his head on that one and move on.
Last shot laid in by Powell. Intercepted by McKnight. Uses the glass and goes in. And they're now behind by three. 2:02 left in the first half. Hooked away. And it's gathered up by number 22. The alley-oop.
Oh.
The Pirates were the last ones to touch it and they'll turn it over.
Try to get fancy and throw it out of bounds.
Oh, Vern, there was no communication on that play. This team needs to start playing together. Not as individuals.
The Golden Eagles turn this one over out of bounds. The Golden Eagles will bring in some players from off the bench.
Sometimes a pass like that can be the fault of the guy in the receiving end. But not that time. That was just a bad look. Out left.
Reynolds unloads. Kane grabs the ball.
The D knows he can make that shot unchecked, and he did a good job standing on the play.
That last basket was buried by Bailey. Reynolds hands it off. What a pass. Gill. Knocks it loose. But it's recovered by Reynolds. Pass baseline. Gill. Gets it outright. Powell passes it to the left. Shot clock dwindling. Throws it up. The shot from the low block by number 14. The Golden Eagles on a bit of a roll here. Howard with the teardrop. He gets hammered. He'll head to the strike.
Just too much contact there, Vern. You're not going to get away with it if you affect the shot that much.
He makes the first.
Seton Hall down seven early.
Number 23 passes it up court. Marquette has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
The Golden Eagles coach could be heard shouting to his players on the floor to help each other in the paint. They've given up way too many points close to the basket. He knows it.
All right, Tracy. He did a nice job of determining what the defense gave him, and he took it.
We see it so often, an area from 10 to 15 being the sweet spot. Reynolds is whistled for reaching in. That will be his second foul of the game. McKnight didn't sit for long, and he's coming back into the ballgame. But it's recovered by Howard. Can't extend the lead to double digits. But they still lead by seven. The bank shot didn't fall by Howard.
Halftime, Hilltopper Refuse Regional. By the way, anybody out there wants to buy a 2007 Dodge Caravan, 143,000 miles, let me know. I got one for sale, 2200. Need struts. Also, if you're hungry, check out some of our local restaurants. You know, Angelini's Pizza, doing some good deals on pizzas. Get some, pick up some takeout. King Street Kitchen, another one with some great food. North Country Steak Buffet, last I checked, was doing some takeout. Crooked Pint, I believe, is doing some takeout. All these places are sponsors of Onalaska football. Go out and represent our community, support our community, I should say, and get some food from these places in you know, tough times right now. So spend your money in our community where people have been supporting us in terms of a football team and athletic program over the years. They help us, let's help them back out. So, Angelini's, King Street Kitchen, North Country Steak Buffet, Baracho's, always a huge sponsor of ours, BA Burrito. Think of any other ones, let me know. Any of our families that own restaurants, let me know. I'll put their name out there. Take the offensive foul there.
Got his feet set and sacrificed the body. Number 23 inbounds the ball. The crossover, McKnight catches it right side. Feeds right wing. Powell throws it up. It's blocked. Number 2, feeds it to the left. Number 25, can't extend the lead with double digits. They still have a 7-point lead. McKnight goes up, fouled hard, and we'll take a trip to the line. Both teams are making a few lineup changes. Gets the second to fall as well. Number 2, inbound for the ball. Samuel runs it off.
Oh, the cans! Before they even knew what hit them, he made off with that one.
Top of the key. Bailey goes up. Slides in with a soft finger. They're up 26-19. Seton Hall is really struggling. Great pass. Gill picks it up. Slams it home. He's shooting 83% of the game. Number 25. Passes it back to the top of the key. In. Number 25 shoots it up. He rips down the rebound.
Seton Hall calls time. 4 minutes left. Marquette up 7. Howard checking back in. Seton Hall on upset alert here.
Inbounds the ball. Just over 4 minutes left in the second half.
Cuts the lead to four. Point lead, 3 minutes left. Stay on him. Down six. Can Seton Hall find a way? Got a shot. Down seven.
159 left in the game. Leads him in. Hill goes up. Right in with a DJ ball over. Terrific feed by number 23. Four assists, and he leads both teams in that category. Howard takes it up. Slides in with a soft.
23 for Howard. Whew. Hard to defend that. Down seven.
Don't deny him on that one. Spins. Bounces it to the elbow. Howard.
Get off of him.
Passes to the right. Howard gets it. Top of the key. Releases. Couldn't make it a double-digit lead on the miss by Kane. They still have a seven-point lead. Howard from long range.
Three shots.
And
cut the lead to four. Still got a shot here. Don't need to foul yet.
Number two, goes up, gets it to the line. Could be a game changer. We'll see.
6 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. The crossover, Hill hands it off. Outright. Kisses it inside. With the leaner, Vance.
He has a great feel for the game and its timing.
He is such an outstanding passer. Howard has picked up his second foul.
They had to foul there. They've got no other option.
Number 23 has picked up his second foul.
Good foul there. They need to ball back as soon as possible.
Hey, Seton Hall forces a turnover. They got a shot. It's going to come down to the end here. This ball going to be inbounded off the side.
Number 23 inbounds the ball. Howell knocked free, but it's retrieved by Gill. Number 22 with this shot doesn't get the go-ahead basket to fall. McKnight has picked up his first foul of the game.
Well, no choice but the foul. They've got to stop the clock and get the ball back right away.
Number 23.
Dog's coming up to see us. He wants to be a part of this comeback. Oh. Can't not get that rebound. Again, can't not get that rebound. Holy cow. I got a 7-footer here and I can't get a rebound. And of course he's going to make them. How do you not get a rebound to seal the game? Marquette is going to move on in this one, folks. If they can sink this free throw, we'll put them on the line. Wow, what an epic collapse by Seton Hall down the stretch. They got the missed free throws that they needed, but could not find a way to get a rebound. So Hilltopper Refuse Regional, that finishes that one up. 16, the round of 16 is set there. Howard with 23 for Marquette. Kansas and Florida. Kansas and Florida in the open season regional. Just the boys, some hockey, and a couple of mocha smoothies. Got the top seed, so I'll be playing with Kansas. 84 versus 82. Should be a good game.
Johnson inbounds the ball. Locke puts it up. There's the opening field goal. They take a 2-point lead. Just over 6 minutes left in the half. Dotson, the crossover. The shot, down low.
Take the foul.
He gets the second to fall as well. Hooks free, and it's scooped up by Gay. Hooked him free, and the game just slows down for him to the point he sees things that others don't. Passes to the free throw line. Number 30 gets the reaching ball and has his first ball of the game.
Oh, you can't come across the body like that. That is a textbook reach.
Johnson inbounds the ball. Number 2. Lewis keeps it to the right.
Oh, man, it's shot by Luck.
And it's all tied up. Just over 5 minutes left in the half. Out left. As a bookie, backs him down. Johnson pulls it in.
Johnson went after that rebound hard. Great work.
Good job on the layup. Good job, shooter. They're in front, 6-4. Dawson brings it up court. Passes to the right block. Dawson gets it, top of the key. Blows it up. The three-point attempt missed by Garrett. Here is the break. Number 2 goes up. Finishes the break. He's got 2. Skip pass, down low. Number 33 hangs and misses. He attacked it with everything he had, but it still wasn't enough.
Good defense, not letting him jam it home.
With the floater, couldn't get the shot, but he was fouled and just a quick of the line. He makes the first of the Jayhawks will bring us to Missouri. Gets them both. Azubuki inbounds the ball. The Jayhawks will try to end this one. Morse blows it up. Miller's the ball. They draw to win in 3. Lewis. Poked loose. Out of bounds. Touched last by Kansas.
The Florida coach, they have to deal with some chemistry issues after those substitutions because that gives them a pretty inexperienced lineup out there.
Anticipates the pass.
I'd love to see that. He's looking around and passing. Such a deep ground.
Has it far side. Number 22 bounces it to the left. Hooked away. The Jayhawks were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
Slow start here for the one-seeded Jayhawks. Florida, pretty good team in this tournament, so it's gonna be a tough matchup. Who am I supposed to be guarding?
Johnson knocks it loose. He's got it up under the 30.
I like how he gets himself into defensive position at the right place,
Has it right wing. Johnson feeds it to the left. Top of the key. Shoots it. The shot was short by Payne. They're still up by one. Nice little crossover. Moss to give them the lead. Payne snatches it down inside.
Nice work by the big fella to get that rebound.
Dumps it off. Leads him with the pass. Stolen by Kenzie. It's one on one.
Not a good entry pass. You just can't force it in there.
Moss catches it on the free throw line. Passes back to the elbow. Raises up. Doesn't get the go-ahead basket to fall. Still a double-digit game. It's picked up by number 30. That's his first steal so far.
He's just been so camped up inside during that making those little dump off passes can be really difficult.
Dustin. Johnson gets the rebound. Quick defensive reaction changed the trajectory. Both teams are going to make some substitutions. Freshier inbounds the ball. Catches it. Cross court. Glover, here's the spin move. Goes up. Converts after the nice spin. They're up by three. The Jayhawks could get 2-for-1 if they hold. Number 13 uses the crossover. Number 22 dumps it off. Kerr feeds it to the right wing. Far side. Number 13. Dumps it down low. Picks it up. The update is a good one, and so is the layup by number 22. They're now behind by one. Lewis has it right wing. Pass to the stripe. Glover. Plays the elbow shot.
Good bucket in the half. Florida finishes the half up 3 in our open season regional. Just the boys, some hockey, and a couple of mocha smoothies. This will be the last game of this session. I'll be live here at around 8:15 or 8:30. Obviously, this one's a tape delay, but we'll be live later tonight.
Starts the second half. Number 2 passes to the wing. Lock. Feeds top of the key. Glover. Gets it. Baseline. Top of the key. Passes it to the right side. Glover. There's a whistle. He gets hammered. Full head to the strike.
At halftime, I caught up with the Jayhawks coach, who told me his team is down, but he's going to push the issue even more in the second half to make a comeback. He continued by saying that his players responded best when they played out of their comfort zone. By mixing things up, he hopes to shape up the opponent's confidence. Back to you, Vern.
Thanks, Gracie. This is it to the top of the key. Azubuki catches it. Baseline. Intercepted. Just over 6 minutes left in the second half.
Whew. Another one seed in trouble here.
Passes out left. Gets
Down 7. I'm cold today. Down 10. Gonna have to chip away at this.
It's loose. The Jayhawks will get this one back. The Kansas coach is gonna let his team have it. He just can't be happy with the run that they've had just now. Well, let's get back to the offense. To the paint. Number 33 inbounds the ball. Skips it far side. Azubuki back in. Number 13.
Here we go.
He's got three. Just over 5 minutes left in the second half. The Gators get their first time out of the game. Both teams are making a few lineup changes. Leads him with the pass. He's 2-for-3 for the game. Number 33 catches it on the left block.
Cut the lead to 7. Got to get a stop here. I don't know. Oh, back up to 10.
Just over 4 minutes left in the second half. Knocks free. And it's picked up by Kansas. Gotcha. Goes up. Finishes the ball.
Cut it to 6.
56% of the game. Florida has not been able to shut down the inside game at all. Tracy is by their bench with a report.
The Gators coach is definitely aware of that problem. He's told his assistants that they have to bring more defenders into the paint, even if it means leaving the perimeter open.
Got to try and cut the lead here. Get it down to 4-3. Cut it to 3. Kansas has a chance.
Johnson backs him down, lobs it down low.
Back up to 5, but 3 minutes left. They got time if they can play some solid defense.
Number 33 has it on the strike. Number 30 dumps it off. Dishes left side, takes it up, puts the shot to their player. They draw to within 3. 2:42 left in the game. Florida, all time. They're in front by 3. 2:37 left in the game. Picked off. Oh, it's a quick win. He couldn't even do one hit that. He made off with that one. Number 33. Raises up. He whips down the rebound.
Down 1.
Flipped it up and out. His team really needs him to hit that.
catches it baseline. Right block, passes back to the wing. Lock, knock loose, and he goes out of bounds. Last touch by Kansas.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. Open season regional here. First game of the open season regional. And one, count it, Kansas back on top. Rock Chuck, Jayhawk expands the lead to two with the and one. Now they gotta play some solid defense, minute 20 left. Went on quite the run here. I think they might be on a 12 point run. Quickly gets the lead back up to five. Kansas going to be shooting free throws when they get the ball back. Florida definitely be trying to foul. Kansas going to salt this one away from the free throw line. Right there will probably be the game. Open region, open season regional, just the boys, some hockey, and a couple of mocha smoothies. A count, but they will still fall to the Kansas Jayhawks, the one seeded Kansas Jayhawks. So that will be it for this midday session. We'll see you later tonight.